Hello, everybody, and welcome back. This is Farron Patronus with the Warriors of Mandalore. And if you've ever found yourself wanting to play Classic WoW, but unfortunately you don't have a whole lot of time so that you can raid or be one of the top tier PvPers, this video's for you. The concept behind today's video is for individuals that like to do PvP but don't necessarily have the time required to either level a character up to 60, or if they do, they don't have the time required to raid or PvP enough so that they can get some of the top tier gear. This makes it definitely a lot more accessible for individuals that have a little bit less time but still have the ability and the knowledge to build a character that is able to PvP with some of the best of them. The concept behind this is called a twink. What a twink is a character that is essentially maxed out with the best gear at its current level. And usually, the way that the level brackets used to work in vanilla WoW is they would go from 10 to 19, 20 to 29, 30 to 39, so on and so forth, and then there was a bracket all on its own at 60. And so what a lot of individuals would do is they would take a character and they would level them up to level 19, and they would max out their gear at that point. They even got to the point that they could enchant the gear using some of the high-end enchants on either weapons or chest pieces, whatever, and that would allow them to have this extra edge. And while stuff like that is a little bit on the it could be seen as an unfair advantage, that is something that everyone has access to. It does certainly help if you have a character that is a higher level that is able to funnel a little bit extra cash into the funds that allows you to do these kinds of things, but it's not necessarily required. The purpose of this series is I'm going to teach you how to not only make a twink, but how to make a good twink. Where to find the gear, what gear works best for you. A lot of the focus is going to be on some of the agility-based classes, so primarily rogues with a little bit on hunters as well. But it's going to be essentially a level 19 twink guide. And today's video is actually going to start out with something that all twinks can use, which is the Grandmaster's Arena Trinket. This is a trinket that is found in the Gurubashi Arena. You actually have to complete the quest 12 times in order to get this trinket. And if you have not done the Gurubashi Arena, or if you haven't heard of it, then in all honesty, that should be no surprise, because the Gurubashi Arena was essentially removed whenever Cataclysm came out and changed up the whole landscape. On top of that, if you still have the trinket today, it is actually pretty darn close to useless. Back in Vanilla WoW, what this trinket would do is whenever you clicked on it, it would give you a gigantic boost to your health. It would give you over 1,000 hit points, which for most twinks in the day, that would essentially double their hit points. Now, it wasn't for a long period of time. It had a very short duration on it, but it did allow you to, say, like if you were running the flag in Warsong Gulch, it gave you a little bit more time to be able to get that flag to the flag room so that you could cap it. One of the downsides to it is that it had a pretty long cooldown on it. So that cooldown pretty much made it to where you could use it once, maybe twice, in an individual battlegrounds, but in all honesty, it had some decent stats otherwise on it that definitely would help you out. The way that I would get this trinket back in the day is I actually got it somewhere in the middle of level 70. So this was during Burning Crusade whenever I acquired this trinket. And what I did is I actually took my level 19 twink, I had gathered up all of the other gear, and I went to the Gurubashi Arena, and it was a rogue. So what I did is I stealthed him there, and then I logged out of that character and logged onto my main, which was also a rogue. It was a level 70 rogue. I actually had some pretty decent gear. I had been doing some arena matches with some of my friends, so my gear was pretty good. It was good enough at the very least that I could hold my own against most enemies. And then I took that character there and put him in the arena and logged out as well. Now, how this arena works is that there is a chest that is placed in the middle of the arena. It's dropped by this NPC here, and it's dropped on the third hour multiple times a day. So it goes at 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 9 o'clock, and then resets back at 12 o'clock. So you have multiple chances throughout the day, every 3 hours, to acquire this. Whenever that chest is dropped, essentially the first person to open it is the one that gets the trinket and any other random items out of that chest. Now, if you're saying, you know, what is the difficulty of that, it is actually pretty, or it was back in the day, it was actually pretty difficult. What would happen is many people would show up. People that were trying to make twinks, people that were just trying to PvP, would all show up. And you weren't just against the opposing faction. Whenever you set foot into the arena, it would place an icon next to your portrait that essentially marked you for PvP against anyone that was not in your party at that point in time. So if you showed up and you were a 19 rogue, you pretty much would have a safe bet of being jumped pretty regularly. Since I was not in a decent-sized guild, or I didn't have a lot of friends that were online at the time that could help me to acquire this, what I did is I kind of worked around the system a little bit. Back then, you didn't have the launcher that Blizzard has today. So what you would do is it was just an executable file, and I would open that executable twice. So I would have two windows, one that was my active window and the other one that was just behind it, so I would alt-tab to it. But the active window would have one of my characters in it, say that it could be my 19 rogue, and that active character would be sitting in the Gurubashi arena just waiting. And what I would do is I would wait whenever the chest would get dropped. I would attempt to get it. If it looked like someone was going to fight me for it, that's whenever I would try to stealth out, get away from the combat, and I would alt-tab and log in on that other window. So what that would do is it would make people think that there's actually two people there, because my 19 rogue would be stealthed, and they wouldn't know if he came out of stealth or if I switched characters. I was actually able to get all 12 of the trinkets using this method, and whenever you get all 12 of the trinkets, you'll go to a quest mob on the edges of the arena itself. And that quest mob will allow you to turn in those 12 trinkets. It's one of those, like, you click on the item to accept the quest sort of things, and you'll get the arena grandmaster trinket. And so if you look at the stats here on that trinket, it is really, really good. So back in the day, that was awesome to have. It took some work, but it was definitely worth it. And it didn't give you a whole lot of experience, which is actually something else that I want to talk about. The thing with twinks, 19 twinks, 29 twinks, all of those back in Vanilla WoW, or you know, whatever expansion you're working with, you used to have to worry about experience. You didn't get experience in Battlegrounds back then, so you didn't have to worry about it with regards to just doing PvP, but you would get experience whenever you were collecting your gear, whatever instances you were running, or if you, say, turned in the quest for the Arena Grandmaster Trinket. So you had to be careful and make sure that whenever you were acquiring your gear, whenever you were going into the instances, you either had to distance yourself far away enough that you weren't getting XP from the mobs, or you had to make sure that you got those items early enough that you were able to have all of the gear you needed and still not accidentally make it to level 20, because that would ruin all of your hard work that you did. Now, some of the really fun aspects of going for this trinket is that you will encounter a lot of people. There's going to be a lot of PvP involved. And in all honesty, I kind of see that as an added bonus, because if something is too easy to achieve, then it's really not going to give you that satisfaction of obtaining it in the end, which is some of the issues they're having with retail WoW right now. Anyway, it's a lot of fun trying to obtain this trinket, and it does take 12 times. You do get a little bit from the trinket initially. That 5 stamina is definitely going to help you out quite a bit, but whenever you get all of those 12 trinkets together, and you get that Arena Grandmaster trinket, the bonuses are going to be really good. It gives you 1% dodge and allows you to absorb, it says 750 to 1251 damage, but in all honesty, that 1251 is always what you're going to experience, which is why it essentially doubles your HP for at least a short duration, about 20 seconds. It does have a 30-minute cooldown, but in all honesty, I feel like that's fair. A lot of people will say that the balance back in Vanilla WoW was not necessarily there, but this trinket is one of those things that actually helped to balance out the game. For a lot of people, they say that the game is in balance, and they're talking about just the class balance. But all of the classes have their own abilities, all classes have their own different jobs they're supposed to accomplish. Some have more CC, some have more damage, some have more heals. That's just, in all honesty, I feel like that should be how it works. If someone is wearing cloth armor and you run up to them and stab them in the back with a knife, they should die. If someone is wearing plate armor and you try to stab them in the back, they shouldn't die. That is how it works. This has been our first video into the voyage of making a classic WoW Twink character, level 19. So if you're enjoying this content, make sure you give it a like, subscribe down below. If you want to support me on Patreon, there's a link to that as well down below the video in the description. If you want to see more videos about how to make a Twink for characters, be sure to put comments down below. And be on the lookout for other guides that will be talking about how to obtain specific weapons and armor for your character to make them the best level 19 Twink that you can possibly have. Thanks for watching. This has been Farron Patronus with the Warriors of Mandalore.